Today, we are going to learn how to convert any 3D 360 VR video into VR 180 video quick and easy. So you can redistribute all your high resolution top and bottom 3D 360 video into the new popular standard VR 180 across Oculus Quest and other VR headsets. Do you want more views with double the resolution without creating new content or spending any more money? Let's go. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. I'm going to start a new series called Essential Tips for VR Filmmakers. These tips are important to VR content creators, but if you have any question in your VR professional journey, please comment below so I will make a video to answer your question in a detailed and professional manner. I helped thousands of VR video content creators throughout my career in the past 3 years. And I think at this point, I have a pretty good idea what you need to know. With the popularity of VR 180, it is a good idea to convert your old VR 360 video into this new format. Most of your 6K to 8K 3D 360 video can be in 5.7K in VR 180, which means the image quality is going to be double and giving you a new chance to redistribute your content in the brand new Oculus TV ecosystem. I cannot say from Oculus perspective because I don't work for them, but you can see the pattern here. Both recent Oculus TV original series, the Tested and the Slow-Mo Guys, are in VR 180. So if you want your content discovered by Oculus and the million of Oculus Go and Oculus Quest users, well, luckily, it is very easy to convert your top and bottom VR 360 video into VR 180, thanks to Google and Adobe. Method 1. Use Google VR 180 Creator Tool. Lots of the content owners are not video editors. You might not even have Adobe Premiere or understand anything about post-production. Instead of hiring someone to do it for you, you can use the Google VR 180 Creator Tool. It is free, thanks to Google. And it is very easy to use. If you have not already, head over to this URL and download the official VR 180 Creator Tool. Install the software, open it up, and select Convert for Editing. Now drop in your 360 video. As you see right here, I have an 8K 3D 360 video shot on the Instar 360 Titan. If I release it as a 3D 360, which I already did, Oculus Quest only allow me to have at most 3840 by 3840 in resolution. But if I convert it into VR 180, I can have 6K VR video, which with the bigger sensor camera like this, the image quality is definitely gonna be amazing. This free tool support ProRes and DNxHR as well. So if you have the master copy in the highest resolution and the highest uncompressed quality, use that version. As you see right here, VR 180 Creator Tool automatically converts your top and bottom into side by side. All the default settings are great. Just make sure you are left and right VR 180 video in 6K and use H.264 as this is the Oculus TV and YouTube VR. Pick the high quality, turn off stabilization as this video is already stabilized professionally in the Mocha Pro. Hit convert. After it is finished, you can simply go to Oculus Media Studio, go to your library. From here, you can upload and publish your media. Method 2 for professional, use Adobe Premiere. What if you want to reframe your center and pick which 180 you want to keep for each cut? Then the best way to do it professionally is with the Adobe Premiere. DaVinci Resolve user, don't worry, we will have a dedicated series to cover all this. First, go ahead and drag the 3D 360 video file here to create a new sequence. Go to Sequence, Sequence Settings, change the frame size to 5760 by 2880. Under VR Properties, make sure the layout changed to stereoscopic side by side and the horizontal captured view to 180 degrees. Keep the rest the same. Please take a moment and make sure your sequence setting is exactly like mine. Now go to Effects and drop in the VR projection under Video Effects, Immersive Videos. Immediately, your top and bottom VR180 video will turn into VR180 side-by-side video. You can turn on toggle VR display to validate that. At this point, feel free to put on your Oculus Quest using link following this tutorial to check the stereo disparity to make sure everything looks right. If you want to change the direction of any moment, make a cut like right here in front of the church. Now, the VR projection effect only affects this particular cut. You can move the pan right here to the direction you want. Now, the center of this cut is facing our talent, which is more desirable for the story. Remember, you are removing 180 degrees of your frame. Your original 360 storytelling needs to be repositioned to make sure the keys of your story are all in the 180 frames. So I will go over each cut and reframe it using the pen to make sure the story flows. After you finish the reframing, go ahead and click File, Export, Media, and let's do it in H.265. This is one of the advantages of using Adobe Premiere instead of the free Google VR180 Creator 2. You can use H.265 to have a better compression ratio to achieve better image quality inside Oculus Quest. The target bitrate I picked is 60 here, and VR video is checked, and frame layout should be stereoscopic side by side in 180 and 180. Check using maximum render quality and go ahead and hit export. Now, the SAMS file can be uploaded onto Oculus Media Studio. Now, you get yourself a VR video in the highest quality. You can also turn your monoscopic 360 video using the exact same workflow. Look at here, it is the mono 360 video captured by the latest techie 360 Anywhere. The review is coming next. Again, apply the VR projection effects like so. It immediately turned the mono 360 video into a VR180 side-by-side format. But you will not have actual 3D. Turn on your toggle VR display. You see there is no stereo disparity, but the output format is correct and Oculus will render it as a VR180 video, just without the VR, the 3D part. If it were just as any other VR180 videos on the Oculus system, as almost 50% of the population cannot really see 3D, so your content will still work. I am not suggesting you should do that, but you can mix in monoscopic video with stereoscopic video using this technique, and it is a great trick to save production money and have more interesting shot in your narrative. Will I choose a cut of a 3D video in a boring studio or a monoscopic cut of Paris? I will choose Paris. Who cares about 3D? It's Paris production value. Method 3, FFmpeg. The third way to do this is documented in details in Eric Chang's personal blog, which I will link in the video description down below. In his blog, there are a lot more useful FFmpeg commands you can use directly to render for Oculus TV or YouTube VR. I would highly recommend you bookmark it as your go-to references. The advantage of FFmpeg is free and open source. Install FFmpeg on your PC or Mac. Open terminal or command prompt on PC like right here. Navigate to your video render folder like so, and drag and drop the location after CD to navigate to the render folder. By the way, to know if you have FFmpeg correctly installed in your system, type FFmpeg-version to make sure you see this. And here is the command line I use to convert my 3D 360 into VR 180. I will provide the full command line in this video description down below, so you can easily copy and paste there. Okay, I hope this video helped you to gain new audience and more distribution channels. As always, let me know in the comment section down below if you have any question. Please support this new series by giving me a thumb up and share it on your social media like Twitter or Facebook. If you are new here, please consider to subscribe and hit the notification bell. We have a lot more VR filmmaking tips and tricks to share, and you don't want to miss that. And I will see you in the next tutorial.